So welcome back to this today's session. So in the last session we have started the permutation and we have seen the three theorems where if you are selecting the R objects from the N, then what is the condition? If you are selecting, repetition is not allowed. If repetition is allowed, then what is the case? And if we want to group some of the R objects, then what is the case? Okay, so let me revise in a minute. So theorem number one says, if suppose you have in total n objects, out of that n objects you are selecting any r objects and repetition is not allowed, then the total number of arrangements of the permutation we can do is npr, which is equals to n factorial upon n minus r factorial. I hope you remember this. Is this okay?
Yes,
okay, perfect. So this was the theorem number one. So theorem number two was like this. If you have n different objects, different is very very important word, different, distinct. So if you have n different objects and you are selecting any r of them and here the repetition is allowed, then the total number of arrangements you could get is what? It is n raised to power of r. Okay, don't remember the formula. These formulas are just tools. Okay, ये तो हम लोगों के बहुत बढ़िया concept से हम लोगों ने समझा लिया है. So n raised to r कैसा आला, npr कैसा आया, ये सब हम लोगों ने देखा है already. Yes, so theorem number 3 is like this. You have n different objects and out of that you are selecting r, no doubt. Okay, you are selecting r, but condition is like that, out of this r any m objects are always together, any m always together, then the total number of permutations, okay, this much we have considered, and for this we have covered the concept, not the formula. Okay, so let me revise the third one because that was, I feel it was a bit confusing for all of us. So let's continue with simple example for the third one. Okay, suppose I have the word like SAM, Sam. Okay, SAM, tell me in how many ways you can arrange these three letters. Yes, in how many ways you can arrange these three letters? Arrange means what? Kiti, how many different words you can form using these three letters?
Six.
Perfect. See here, we have total three letters and all of them I want to arrange. Means n is equals to 3, r is equals to 3. So it is npr, which is nothing but n factorial. Manje hai asa pan bagu shakta tumhi. Ek, don, teen places hai. For first place you have three options, second place two options, for third place one option. So 3 into 2 is 6. Is this okay? ये तो हो गया टोटल नंबर ऑफ अरेंजमेंट्स. मीन्स वॉट, इफ रिमेंबर, इट इज अ ट्रिक. इफ यू हैव थ्री ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू अरेंज ऑल ऑफ देम देन द आंसर इज ऑलवेज इक्वल्स टू 3 फैक्टोरियल. मीन्स इन दिस केस, इफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर 5, देन आंसर विल बी 5 फैक्टोरियल. इफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर 6, द आंसर विल बी 6 फैक्टोरियल. इफ यू आर अरेंजिंग ऑल ऑफ देम, इज इट ओके? If you are arranging all of them, then this is the case. I hope it is okay. Everyone.
Yes,
sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see, the third theorem says that I want the words having S and M always together. S and M. In the words, I want S and M always together. Means see here, I have the word Sam, S-A-M, Sam. So what are the words in which I will get S and M together? So this could be the case, S-M-A, M-S-A. Okay, so first let's write down all the words which are starting with S and M. Okay, SMA, then we have ASM. Can I write MAS?
No, sir.
No, you nice, cannot sir. Write MAS because that is not satisfying the condition. I want S and M together. Okay, so SMA ho gaya, ASM ho gaya. So can I have MSA? Can I have MSA?
No, sir. Oh.
Why no? Yes. See here, what I want S and M always together. This is the case, na, where S and M are together. Okay, so this is okay, this is perfect, no problem here. AMS, this is also okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now see, for if you consider SM, we have two words. If you consider MS, we have two words. So total kitna aa gaya boss? Total aa gaya sir, 4. So total I have the 4 words. In which I have S and M always together. अभी इसको करना कैसा है देखो यार. Whenever they say always together, form a group of those objects. Always together जो objects है उनका एक group बना दो. So I have made a group SM. Okay, उनका एक group हो गया. This is one object. Treat this as a one object. Now remaining, how many letters are remaining? Only one letter is remaining. So write down that letter. So only one letter is remaining. That is one. Okay. So treat these two as a different entity. These two are the different objects. Ek ani don. Now I want to permute both of these objects. So what is the answer for that? I want to arrange both of these objects. Now you have total two different objects, 1 and 2. These are the two different objects we are looking. Now I want to permute, arrange both of these objects. So what will be the answer? Just now I told you that is saha objects la arrange karal 6 factorial 5 la karal 5 factorial ithe mala doganna karay sir kitya factorial le answer it is 2 factorial is it okay so for arranging these two different objects I have total 2 factorial ways means there are total number of 2 options we have for arranging this SM and the remaining one letter is this okay ithe paranta
Oh, sir.
Okay, ये तो हो गया भाई SM. If I consider SM, now this S and M, I can rearrange them in between. SM पन लिख सकते हो, क्यों MS पन लिख सकते हो ना? So S and M, I can arrange in between. So in how many ways you can arrange this SM? In how many ways you can arrange the S and M? दोन लेटर्स आहेत दोघांनाही मला अरेंज करायचं किती लागेल दोन फॅक्टर लिहिले ना त्याचा पण पूर्ण ओके सो द इन टोटल हाऊ मेनी टोटल ऑप्शन्स यू हॅव एसएम इन बिटवीन दे कॅन अरेंज इन द टू वेज टू फॅक्टरल वेज अँड दीज टू डिफरंट ऑब्जेक्ट्स एस अँड एम दिस फर्स्ट ऑब्जेक्ट अँड द सेकंड ऑब्जेक्ट इन टू फॅक्टरल वेज सो युअर आन्सर इज टू फॅक्टरल इन टू फॅक्टरल नथिंग बट 4 दॅट्स इट दिस इज द सेम आन्सर Okay, it will be again very clear if I take one more example here. So let's take the second example like this. M, N and P, Q. Suppose I have this word M, N, P, Q. And my condition is like that now. I want M, P and Q always together. I want M, P, Q always together. Okay, so what we know that if always together... If it is always together case, then what to do? Yes, means what? Form a group. Form a group. Kiska group form karna hai? Jo saath mein hone wale, uska group form karna hai. So, M and Q, you want? Inka group form kar do. Raila kon? M and Q jala. Raila kon? P raila. So, kiti hai total te? 1. Okay. Now, how many different objects you can see now?
Two
different objects. See, this circle one is one object. Ye ek ho gaya and ye dusra ho gaya. So, we have total 2 objects. Now, I want to permute both of these. So, in how many ways you can arrange that? I want to arrange these both objects. See, red mark जे केले ते दोघांनाही मला arrange करायचे आहे. दोन आहेत, दोन आहेत तर दोघांनाही दोन फॅक्टोरियल मध्ये मी arrange करू शकतो. These are the two objects. I want to arrange these both of these two objects. So that will be in the two factorial ways. बघा इथे तुम्हाला जर ते समजत नसेल तर कन्सेप्ट लक्षात घ्या ना. किती ऑब्जेक्ट आहेत तुमच्याकडे? दोन ऑब्जेक्ट आहेत, एक आणि एक ऑब्जेक्ट आणि दोन ऑब्जेक्ट. पहिल्या प्लेसाठी किती ऑप्शन येतो तुमच्याकडे? आयदर हा बसू शकतो इथे किंवा हा बसू शकतो. किती ऑब्जेक्ट आहेत? आता बघा, मी ह्याला एक ट्रीट करतोय. हे मी टोटल एक ग्रुप बनवलं म्हणजे काय, मी ह्याला एक वर्ड एक लेटरच ट्रीट करतोय. मी ह्याला तीन लेटर नाही येत, एकच लेटर ट्रीट करतोय. सो हा एक लेटर झाला आणि हा एक लेटर झाला. सो इथे आला दोन ऑप्शन्स आहेत. मग इथे किती राहिला? इथे एकच ऑप्शन राहील. दॅट्स वाय इट कम्स ॲज अ टू फॅक्टोरियल. आय होप इट इज ओके. सो दीज टू डिफरंट ऑब्जेक्ट्स कॅन बी अरेंज इन टू फॅक्टोरियल वेज. ओके, बट इफ यू सी इनसाइड दिस रेड बॉक्स, इनसाइड दिस रेड बॉक्स वी हॅव ॲक्च्युअली थ्री लेटर्स. नाव दोज थ्री लेटर्स कॅन ऑल्सो बी रिअरेंज्ड. सो थ्री लेटर्स कॅन बी अरेंज इन हाऊ मेनी वेज? थ्री फॅक्टोरियल वेज. सो इन तीनों का जो खुद में जो अरेंजमेंट करना है, दॅट विल बी इन द थ्री फॅक्टोरियल वेज. सो इन टोटल युअर आन्सर विल बी वॉट? ह्या मधल्यांना पण मला अरेंज करायचं आहे आणि ह्या दोघांना पण अरेंज करायचं. सो आन्सर विल बी वॉट? इट इज थ्री फॅक्टोरियल इन टू टू फॅक्टोरियल, विच इज सिक्स इन टू टू, विच इज इक्वल्स टू 12. दिस इज युअर आन्सर. सो गेटिंग दिस कन्सेप्ट इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट बॉस, व्हेरी व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. इन एनी कॉम्पिटिटिव एक्झामिनेशन यू सी दीज टाईप ऑफ क्वेश्चन्स, व्हेरी फेमस क्वेश्चन्स. इज दिस ओके?
यस सर.
परफेक्ट. ओके ओके. सो विथ दिस लेट्स स्टार्ट द एक्सरसाइज 3.3 अँड वी विल सी सम ऑफ द क्वेश्चन्स विच वी हॅव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड द कन्सेप्ट. Okay, so exercise 3.3, so let me have the questions here. I will not write the questions. Okay, so exercise 3.3, in this first, second, third and fourth we will see afterwards. Okay, first let's try to cover these word problems which are very very important. Okay, so the first four we will see after two lectures. And let's directly start with the which question you want. Okay, let's start with the question number 5 itself. Okay, so let me take the question number 5 there. So here we go for the question number 5. Okay. See, it says that how many four letter words can be formed using the letters in the word Madhuri if letters can be repeated and letters cannot be repeated. Okay, you want to arrange all the letters from the word Madhuri. Okay, and you want to pick any four here. So tell me, what is the value of n? N means what? Total available letters. किती आहेत तुमच्याकडे?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
सो आय हॅव 7 लेटर्स अँड वॉट इज आर व्हॅल्यू? यू वॉन्ट टू पिक एनी 4 देन. ओके, सो एनी 4. रिपिटेशन इज अलाउड बोला आहे. सो युअर आन्सर इज वॉट? 7 raised to 4?
येस
येस.
सी, ये तो हो गया डायरेक्ट फॉर्मूला से. कंसेप्ट क्या बोलता है? यू वांट टू पिक एनी 4, सो यू टेक 4 प्लेसेस हियर, 1, 2, 3, 4 प्लेसेस. फॉर द फर्स्ट प्लेस हाउ मेनी ऑप्शंस यू हैव? 7. फॉर द सेकंड प्लेस एज रिपीटेशन इज अलाउड, 7 अगेन 7 अगेन 7. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट 7 raised to 4. नाउ द B1 इज लाइक दिस, द रिपीटेशन इज नॉट अलाउड, देन व्हाट विल बी द आंसर? It is 7P4. Repetition is not allowed, 7P4. I want to select any 4 out of the 7, so which is nothing but 7P4. So which is nothing but 7 factorial divided by 7 minus 4 is 3 factorial, which is nothing but 7 into 6 into 5.
सर इथं 4 पण येणार ना
सर 3 पण येणार ना सर 7 into 6 into 5
कॅन्सल केलं ना आपण
काय काय
3 फॅक्टोरियल
हां अजून एक येईल सॉरी सर यस यस अजून एक येईल सॉरी 4 पण येईल सो 7 डिक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर मध्ये 4 वेळेस लिहायचं आहे सो 1 2 3 4 4 वेळेस आला सो दिस इज युअर आंसर इज दिस ओके 74
हो सर
सो कॉन्सेप्ट क्या होता है चार प्लेसेस है अपने पास फर्स्ट प्लेस ला किती ऑप्शन्स आहेत 7 सेकंडला 6 नंतर 5 आणि नंतर 4 सो दिस इज द कॉन्सेप्ट सो दीज आर द टू आंसर्स यू हैव सो 7:4 इज द फर्स्ट आंसर एंड 7p4 इज द सेकंड आंसर इज दिस ओके
यस सर
परफेक्ट ओके लेट्स सी द नेक्स्ट वन क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस 6th क्वेश्चन I am very sure that you can solve any question from this exercise. It is as important as that. So question number 6. So we will invest our time in the question number 6. Okay. Determine the number of arrangements of the letters of the word algorithm if vowels are always together. No two vowels are always together. Consonants are at even positions and O is the first and T is the last letter. Okay, so see here, let's first understand what are the vowels and consonants. I hope you know that. So we will represent the vowels by V, which is A, E, I, O and U. These are all vowels. We have 5 vowels in total and the remaining are all the consonants. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, first write down this given word algorithm as it is. A-L-G-O-R-I-T-H-M. So, this is what we have total word algorithm. So, what is the value of N? Means what? All the letters. So, count karakite. 1, 2, 3, 7. 4, 5, 7. 6, 7, 8, 9. So, I have total 9 letters in this word algorithm. How many vowels we have in this case?
3.
So we have A. Okay.
I,
we
O.
have I, O, I, O, and we have I. So these are the 3 vowels we have. So how many consonants then? 3 vowels. Mm-hmm. Total, tumchakade 9 ahet. Tyachyatle 3 vowels ahet. Mag rahilele 6 je ahet. Te consonants rach rahnar ahet definitely.
Ho sir.
Perfect. Now. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ये तो हो गया भाई गिवन ये दिस एवरीथिंग इज अ गिवन नाउ फर्स्ट लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ए वॉवेल्स आर ऑलवेज टुगेदर सो व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू नोट नोट वाज लाइक दैट व्हेन एवर यू गेट द क्वेश्चन लाइक ऑलवेज टुगेदर व्हाट टू डू ऑलवेज टुगेदर इफ द केस व्हाट टू डू
ग्रुप
फॉर्म अ ग्रुप फॉर्म अ ग्रुप ओके सो कौन कौन ऑलवेज टुगेदर में है वॉवेल्स आर ऑलवेज टुगेदर सो फॉर्म अ ग्रुप ऑफ ए ओ एंड आई ओके फॉर्म दिस ग्रुप ओके सर ग्रुप तो फॉर्म हो गया उसके बाद क्या करना है राइट डाउन ऑल द रिमेनिंग लेटर्स हियर कौन कौन है 1 2 3 4 5 6 सो ऑल द 6 लेटर्स आर रिमेनिंग हियर आई होप इट इज ओके
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, how many total distinct objects you have?
7.
In this case, 7. Karan hai vegvegle 6 objects hai jithe. These 6 means what? These are the 6 different objects we have. So, this 6 plus this 1 is what? Total 7 different objects I am having. So these 7 different objects can be arranged in how many ways?
7 factorial
ways. Excellent. So is this your final answer? No. Because this A, O, I can also be arranged in between them. So in how many ways you can arrange them?
3 factorial.
3 factorial. Excellent. Now you people are getting. So what is your final answer then? So final answer is what?
7 into 3 factorial.
So and है ना यहाँ पे सर ही पूर्ण सात जन ना अरेंज कराए चाहे and I have to consider this A O I arrangement in between them also. So what is my final answer is ओके मग ह्याला तुम्ही असं पण लिहू शकता म्हणजे तुम्हाला जर समजून घ्यायचं म्हणजे लिहायची मेथड जर बघायची असेल ना सो दिस ब्रॅकेट मीन्स दिस डब्बा कॅन बी अरेंज इन सेवन फॅक्टोरियल मीन्स सो यू टेक द इन टू सो दिस इज वॉट माय आन्सर इज सो थ्री फॅक्टोरियल इन टू सेवन फॅक्टोरियल कीप दिस ॲज इट इज नो प्रॉब्लम इफ यू वॉन्ट ठीक आहे अगर ज्यादा मार्क्स के लिए क्वेश्चन रहेगा तो हम लोगों को सॉल्व करना पड़ेगा सो थ्री फॅक्टोरियल इज तुम्हारे सिक्स सेवन फॅक्टोरियल कितना है इट इज अ सिक्स फॅक्टोरियल किती आहे I hope you have done the homework. What is 7 factorial is? अरे क्या हो गया? 5040. Very good. So कितना आ गया भाई ये 0? 24 और 35. So 30240 is the final answer. So these many, imagine just with the help of these 9 letters, how many words you are getting? 30,240 different words I am getting in which A, O, I are together. Imagine the number of count we are getting here. This is the power of permutation. Can we write all these words here? No, definitely we cannot write. Liu shakta, but it will take bahut time lagega isko. Samajhte ga? Understanding this question is very, very important. Is it okay?
Yes.
Oh, sir.
Sir, please respond.
Six check only 7 factorial कसं काय आलो माझी मधी रेंज गेली होती ऐकताना आलो मला. हां.
हे बघा इथे 6 म्हणजे काय? These 6 are nothing but what? These are the 6 consonants we are having. कारण हे तीन जेव्हा तुम्ही इथे ग्रुप केलात ना, ह्या तिघांना मी एक ग्रुप ट्रीट करतोय. A O I. आता A O I गेल्यानंतर राहिले कोण-कोण हो? L राहिला. जी राहिला आर राहिला टी एच एम हे सहा जण राहिले ते सहा जण मी इथे लिहिलं आहे इज इट ओके आता हे सहा प्लस हा एक टोटल मोठा ग्रुप म्हणजे टोटल 7 ग्रुप झाले तुमच्याकडे ह्या दोघांना मिळून इज इट ओके टोटल 7 ग्रुप झाले इथे आता त्या 7 ग्रुपला मी अरेंजमेंट करायचे तर दॅट कॅन बी डन इन द 7 फॅक्टोरियल वेज दिस 6 plus this red one is 1 so 6 plus 1 is 7 so it can be arranged in 7 factorial ways and this AOI can also be rearranged in between them in 3 factorial ways because there are 3 letters so it can be arranged in 3 factorial ways is this okay range konachi keli hoti is it okay kalala ka ओके सो अभी इसका फॉर्मूला कैसा होता है सर इफ यू वॉन्ट टू हैव द फॉर्मूला डायरेक्टली इफ यू डोंट वॉन्ट कंसेप्ट एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट फॉर्मूला देन वॉट ऑलवेज रिमेंबर इट्स फॉर्मूला इज लाइक दिस एम फैक्टोरियल इन टू एन माइनस एम प्लस वन फैक्टोरियल वेयर एम इज वॉट दिस इज द नंबर ऑफ लेटर्स इन अ ग्रुप ऑलवेज टुगेदर सपोज एम ऑलवेज टुगेदर सो दिस बिकम्स 3 इन आवर केस आपल्या केसमध्ये काय 3 आहे सो एम इज वॉट ऑलवेज टुगेदरचे वर्ड्स आहेत लेटर्स आहेत ऑलवेज टुगेदर लेटर्स सो हाऊ मेनी ऑलवेज टुगेदर वी हॅव हिअर इज 3 सो इट इज 3 फॅक्टोरियल इन टू एन कितना आहे आपल्या केसमध्ये 9 मायनस 3 प्लस 1 फॅक्टोरियल सो इट इज 3 फॅक्टोरियल इन टू 9 मायनस 3 इज 6 6 प्लस 1 इज 7 दॅट्स इट सो 3 फॅक्टोरियल इन टू 7 फॅक्टोरियल सेम थिंग So this is the formula you can have. But I highly recommend to understand this concept because formula is a question specific and the concept is what? It is generalized. No problem if you remember this formula also. But it is always good to have the concept also. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
सर्दी झाली ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट नो टू वॉवेल्स आर ऑलवेज टुगेदर वी विल सी इन अ शॉर्ट टाइम D is very easy. You can solve this D because this type of questions we have already solved. O is the first and T is the last. Sangu shakta answer? O is the first and T is the last. Are we have seen this type of questions in the last class, yesterday only. So question number D is what? Is algorithm in which the letters are like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. So what they want? O is the first and T is the last. So O is the first and T is the last. So in how many ways you can fill this first place?
One.
Only one. What about the last place?
One.
Only one. What about this second place?
Seven.
Seven. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So what is your
seven
answer
factorial.
Then?
7 factorial.
This is nothing but the 7 factorial. So this is the answer to your last question D. 7 factorial. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. No, sir. Now coming back to the very, very important question, which is a B. No two vowels are together. So B is no two vowels are together. No two vowels are together. Okay. Now see here, we have the word like algorithm. Algorithm. Total 9. Note. No two vowels, no two together, if we have this case, no two together, if we have this case, implies what to do? Go for alternate arrangement. Alternate arrangement means what? See here. No two vowels, matlab, dusra kon hai bhai entity? Vowels ke saath aayenge consonants. This is our different, another entity, vowels and consonants. No two vowels together, so can consonants be together then? Yes, no problem. Consonants together aaye to problem nahi hai. Vowels saath mein nahi chahiye. Means what? I don't want A and O together. A, O, I together, no, I don't want. Any of these three, I don't want that together. So how you can arrange them, sir? See here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Alternate arrangement means what? Arrange the like this. So vowel, consonant, vowel, consonant, vowel, consonant, vowel, consonant, vowel, consonant, and so on and so forth. Means if we do the alternate arrangement of these two different entities, then you will satisfy the given condition, that is no two vowels are always together. See, this vowel is apart from this. This one is away from this. These all the vowels are always apart. They are not together. Okay. So in this case, no two vowels together means what? We have to first arrange the consonants. You have to first arrange the consonants. So let's have all these 9 places here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Okay. So I want to arrange all the consonants first. Vowels together nahi bola hai. I don't want the no two vowels together. So first arrange the consonants. Alternate arrangement plus first arrange other entity. Okay, vowels bola hai to first arrange the consonants. So how many consonants we have?
Six
consonants. In total, I have total 6 consonants. Okay. So for all these 6 consonants, okay. For all these 6 consonants, in how many ways you can arrange those 6 consonants?
6 factorial.
6 factorial ways.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's, I have arranged those consonants like this. C1, C2, C3, C4, C5 and C6. Okay, so the arranging the consonant gives me the answer as a 6 factorial. Now you want to arrange the vowels now. Atta vowels kutte thevnar? Kutla hi don consonants cha कुठल्याही दोन कॉन्सोनंटच्या मध्ये एक वॉवेल यायला पाहिजे, किंवा आपण असं म्हणू शकतो की दोन वॉवेलच्या मध्ये एक कॉन्सोनंट कंपल्सरी यायलाच पाहिजे. इन बिटवीन एनी टू वॉवेल्स आय वॉन्ट ऍटलीस्ट वन कॉन्सोनंट लाईक दिस. इफ आय हॅव दिस इज वी फर्स्ट वॉवेल हिअर, यू कॅन हॅव वी हिअर, यू कॅन हॅव वी हिअर, यहाँ पे यहाँ पे यहाँ पे यहाँ पे एंड यहाँ पे. सी इफ दिस इज द केस देन आवर गिवन कंडीशन इज व्हेरी सॅटिस्फाईड. व्हॉट इज दॅट? नो टू वॉवेल्स आर टुगेदर. नो टू, इफ यू सी हियर, नो टू वॉवेल्स आर टुगेदर. इज दिस ओके? आर यू गेटिंग दिस?
हो सर.
ओके, सो मीन्स हाऊ मेनी फेवरेबल पोझिशन्स वी हॅव फॉर वॉवेल्स?
सेवन.
मेनी फेवरेबल पोझिशन्स? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So in these 7 positions I can place the vowels. Is it okay?
Yes.
Now tell me, for this place how many options you have?
3.
Okay, we'll go in some different way. So how many vowels we have in total? 3 vowels. Is it okay?
Yes.
So 3 vowels आहेत आपल्याकडे, ए आहे, ओ आहे अँड आय आहे. टेल मी फॉर ओ हाऊ मेनी ऑप्शन्स आर देअर? फॉर ए हाऊ मेनी ऑप्शन्स आर देअर? ए कॅन बी प्लेस इन एनी वेअर इन दीज 7 ऑप्शन्स.
येस.
ओके, ए इज हॅव्हिंग 7 ऑप्शन्स. वॉट अबाउट ओ? हाऊ मेनी ऑप्शन्स ओ इज हॅव्हिंग?
6.
देन आय?
5.
सो दिस इज नथिंग बट दी 7 6 5. मीन्स वॉट? इट इज नथिंग बट दी 7 P 4. Means you are selecting any 4 places, sorry, any 3 places. You are selecting any 3 places out of 7. Because I have 3 vowels, you are selecting any 3 places. Now we are selecting the places, huh? For 3 vowels out of 7. So this is known as 7P3. So total answer is what? It is 6 factorial into 7P3, which is 6 factorial into 7 6 5. Is this okay?
Oh,
okay. So ek ajun ek question ko te has types of which is not there in your exercise. Suppose you have 12 English books and 4 maths books. I want to arrange in such a way that no maths books are always together. No two maths books together. I want that case. Okay? Arrange all these 16 books such a way that no two maths together. Okay? So no together case means what? We have to consider the alternative arrangement. And for that first we have to arrange the opposite entity. So yahan pe maths and English hai, ithe maths dile, then first you place the English words. So there are total 12 English books. So in how many ways you can arrange those 12? Question samajh lagao. Is question okay?
Yes.
You have total 12 English books and 4 mathematics books. And I want to arrange all these 16 books in such a way that no two maths books are together. So for that purpose, what we'll do, we will go for the alternative arrangement. And first I will arrange all the opposite books, that is the English books. So in how many ways you can arrange these 12 English books?
12 factorial
ways. Okay. Now, 12 factorial ways. Now how many places you have for mathematics then? Baka ite. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 11 12. So these are the 12 English books you have placed already. Now let's see for the mathematics how many favorable places we have. Tumhi maths ite theu shakta? इथे ठेवू शकता. म्हणजे कुठल्याही दोन मॅथमेटिक्समध्ये एक इंग्लिश बुक यायलाच पाहिजे. Is this okay? The arrow indicates the position for mathematics. Are you getting? No? Yes. Correct. Okay. So how many favorable options you have for mathematics?
6.
Array. Count karo.
13.
Yes, there are 13 favorable positions for mathematics. Kuthe hi tu shakta tumhe mathematics the book.
13 kasa sir?
Baga na ithe red arrows ki tier. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 kasa jale manje he 11 jale asel red black wale 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 so we have placed the 12 English books. And these are the total position for favorable position for mathematics. Is it okay? Okay. So how many favorable position for mathematics we have is 13. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. So 4 mathematics and I have the 13 places. So I want any 4 places out of these 13. So that can be written as 13P4. This is what the answer is. Getting?
Yes.
Oh, sir.
Another example I can give. There are suppose 5 boys and 3 girls. Okay. Now I want to arrange all of these 8 students such a way that no 2 girls are together. No 2 girls are together. Okay. No 2 girls together. So what will be the case now? No 2 girls together means what you will do? We will arrange boys first. So in how many ways you can arrange boys?
5 factorial ways.
Okay, so once you have 5, you have placed 5 boys, then how many favorable positions you will have for girls?
6.
6. Bagai the 1 2 3 4 5 ye 5 boys ho gaye. Abhi no 2 girls together means what? Do girls ke beech mein ek banda chahiye. Okay, so these are the favorable positions then for girls. Yes or no?
Yes.
You can place girls anywhere in these 6 places. So favorable positions for always the given entity is what? It is 1 plus this. Getting? Karan sagli kade bagat sat jale. Ite 12 English books hai. Favorable position for maths kit jale ho? 13. 12 plus 1 13. Te chadi cha case madhe. We had 6 consonants. So favorable condition for places for vowels kitna gaya? 7. 6 plus 1, 7. Okay, so it is 5 factorial. This for your boys. Now, how many favorable positions for girls is 6?
6P3.
So, your answer is what? It is a 6P3. Is this okay? 6P3.
Yes.
Perfect. I hope you are getting this now.
Oh, sir.
Let's have one more question. Now tell me the answer to this question. I have total 10 green balls and 8 black balls. No 2 black together. No 2 black together. So what will be the answer? No 2 black together.
10 factorial into 11P8.
Kon hai tumhe?
Shalaka.
Okay. Perfect. Excellent. Okay. So no 2 black together means what? No 2 together means what? The case is alternative case. where we have to first arrange the opposite entity. So opposite entity black है, तो opposite कौन है? Green है. So first arrange all of them. So can be arranged in 10 factorial ways. Into, so if there are 10 green balls, then how many favorable positions for 8 balls? 11. Okay. So out of those 11 positions, I want to pick any 8. So this will be the answer. Samajhte?
Oh, sir.
Ketki, are you getting?
Oh, sir.
Okay, Vaidehi?
Oh, sir, Kailo.
Rohit, Atharva, Sakshant, Kshitij?
Kailo, sir.
Vishwanil? Ashok?
Oh, sir.
ठीक है सो इफ सपोज आई गिव द क्वेश्चन लाइक दिस नाउ लेट्स सी हु विल गिव द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन अरेंज ऑल दीज 18 बॉल्स सच दैट ऑल ग्रीन बॉल्स टुगेदर ऑल ग्रीन बॉल्स टुगेदर व्हाट विल बी द आंसर एनीवन All green balls together.
Eight factorial into 10 factorial.
नहीं.
11 factorial.
18 factorial into 10 factorial.
Okay, we have the options here. First option was like काय सांगितलं पहिला option कोणी सांगितलं होतं?
8 factorial into 10 factorial.
कौन है शला का
निकिता
निकिता ओके हाँ सेकंड ऑप्शन 11 फैक्टोरियल संगीत लगाने तेरे थर्ड ऑप्शन
18 फैक्टोरियल इनटू 10 फैक्टोरियल
ओके सो एनी अदर ऑप्शन सो माय ऑप्शन इज नन ऑफ दिस कुटला बरोबर
है नन ऑफ दिस
का बर
सर ग्रीन सा पूर्ण एक बंच आनी
हाँ हाँ
एट उरले तर सरळ सरळ 8 फॅक्टोरियल घेतलं
ओके बरोबर आहे अर्ध पण अर्ध बरोबर आहे पण सो ऑलवेज टुगेदर मीन्स व्हाट वी हैव टू फॉर्म अ ग्रुप सो फॉर्म अ ग्रुप ऑफ 10 ग्रीन बॉल्स इसका एक ग्रुप आ गया भाई राहिले किती हो टोटल 8 ब्लॅक बॉल राहिले ना
हो
टोटल किती डिफरेंट बॉल्स झाले तुमच्याकडे आता 9 factorial then so it is 9 factorial kiska in total ka but these 10 different balls can arrange in between them which again is 10 factorial so this is your answer 10 factorial into 9 factorial are you getting
ho sir
ho
come back to this question 5 boys and 3 girls give me the question answer to this question like All boys together. All boys together का ऐसे.
Five factorial into four factorial.
Yes, it's five factorial into four factorial.